According to the Commissioner of Transport Regulation and Safety in the Ministry of Works and Transport, Winston Katushabe, last year the country lost over 1,400 border riders in road crashes, and over 400 border passengers also lost their lives. School-going children were not spared. Upon this report and concerns, the Transport Ministry is set to put more emphasis on the use of helmets for passengers. Tough penalties await those who will not abide.
Road traffic injuries are the seventh leading cause of death in hospitals, health facilities in Uganda. Here you are talking of HIV, cancer and the rest. But when it comes to injuries, borders are the first. So it is a serious.
Katushabe made the remarks during the launch of the Heads Up Child Safety Helmets campaign by Vivo Energy Uganda, which is intended to promote the use of safety helmets for children that use borders to commute to school.
As we look at these issues of road safety, wearing of helmet, I think also we need also to be considerate. I think Naruman, since you are part of this, we need to quickly look into this. We would want this year to launch bigger campaigns. We'll work with the KCCA, we'll work with local governments as a ministry to sensitize the public about use of roads.
The use of child safety helmets is one of the most effective methods of preventing head injury in the event that a child gets accident with a border.
Kaduchu also noted that plans are underway to have road safety taught in primary schools.
As Minister of Education and Sports, ladies and gentlemen, we encourage schools to also include safety training as a topic during their extracurricular activities like the sports, music and drama.
The Kampala Metropolitan Traffic Police Commander, Roger Sincerico, said having helmets for passengers and riders is key while on the road.
I'm much excited about this project of the helmet use, because so many people die, yet actually they would have survived that crash had they put on the helmet.
According to officials, helmets provide vital protection to the head and the brain, and they can help lower the risk of serious injury by reducing the impact of force to the head in an unfortunate event that a passenger is involved in an accident. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.